Today, I'll be walking you through step by step in a straightforward and easy to follow manner on how to make a vintage mountain logo using Adobe Illustrator. Before we start, I'm going to very quickly show you the tools and windows you are going to use in this tutorial. We will be using the Align window quite often. Also, the Stroke and Pathfinder windows are going to come in handy. And finally, the Type Character window. As far as tools go, we are going to utilize a Direct Selection tool, the Type on the Path tool, the various shape tools, the scissors tool, and of course, because this is Illustrator, the pen tool. Now let's jump right into this tutorial. Take the pen tool and with the stroke selected with no fill, make a shape of a two mountain peaks similar to mine here. Hit Command R to bring up the rulers and drag down a guide so we can make the bottom of the mountain peaks level. Then take your pen tool and finish the path. Switch the shape to a fill. With the Direct Selection tool, highlight the shape and curve the points here. You didn't have to do this, but it's optional. Select white or any color that's different from your shape, and then select the stroke option. To add a snow effect, we are going to take the pen tool and make some shapes over the mountain and cut them out. Switch the shape to a fill and select both shapes. In the Pathfinder window, select minus front option. This will cut out the white shape from the mounting. We will do this again one more time with a larger shape. You can get creative and make the snow any shape and style you wish. You can take the Direct Selection tool and edit your path easily. I'm going to curve the corners here on the snow, which again is optional. We now have the mountain peak for our vintage mountain logo using Adobe Illustrator. We now want our main phrase or the word that's going to go in the middle, so choose something fairly short. If you like this typeface, here is the name. You can easily search this on Google. We can select both items and align them centrally like so. Hold down and click over the Shape tool and select the Star tool. Double click on the canvas and generate a star similar to mine here. If it is not made leveled, we can bring down a guide and rotate it to be level. Hold down Alt until you see this icon appear and duplicate the star. Then do that again until you have 5 stars. Highlight them all, and then in the line window, select this to evenly space them. Also, hit Command G to group them, or go up to Object and Group. Now, we will make an arrow to go below the stars, so take the pen tool and hold down Shift to make a straight line. Increase the stroke weight, and then in the stroke window, round off the end of the line for a better effect and look. Make a new line and hold down Shift, but this time, move the cursor diagonally to make a 45 degrees line. Place it and then duplicate. Go up to Object, Transform and Reflect. Select all lines and then outline the stroke like so. Highlight them again, and then in the Pathfinder window, join them together. Make 5 more diagonal lines for the tail. You can evenly space them with the Pathfinder as we did with the stars. Duplicate, reflect, and then place them with the others. Once your arrow is finished, outline the stroke again and pull it below the stars. We are nearly finished, guys. Now take the ellipse tool and create a circle by holding down Shift and Alt. But make sure it is only a stroke and not a fill. This is going to be where our second lot of text is going to go. We can align everything centrally to make it look perfect. Highlight the circle and take the scissors tool. We want to click on each of the two anchors horizontally. Take the Type on a Path tool and type in your text at the top. With the Direct Selection tool, look for this line here and drag the text around so it's central. I feel the air getting colder. I know something's missing here. Go ahead and do the same for both. You will notice it types upside down here. Look for this line and flip the text over. Align it as before. The circle lines will be invisible after we finished. The last touch we're going to make to our vintage logo in Adobe Illustrator is to add two circles on the outside. Make a thick stroke circle on the outside. I am just making sure everything is aligned. Duplicate the circle and then make it slightly larger, lowering the stroke weight. There, you have it. How to make a vintage mountain logo using Adobe Illustrator. If you like this tutorial, smash that like button and subscribe for weekly uploads of speed art videos and tutorials. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.